Hi friends, now we will read a poem relating to law and order, what we call law and order in society. So law is very, very important in society. So this story, this shloka is about that. Let us read the shloka. Danda shasti praja sarvaha.
Danda shasti praja sarvaha.
Danda eva bhirakshati.
Danda eva bhirakshati.
Danda supteshu jagarti. दंडम धर्मम विदुर्बुधाः सो दिस इज अ श्लोक फ्रॉम व्हाट इज कॉल्ड मनुस्मृति द कोड ऑफ मनु सो यू नो दैट देयर वाज वन ग्रेट लॉ गिवर कॉल्ड मनु ऑफ कोर्स विदाउट रीडिंग दैट बुक मेनी पीपल नाउडेज दे क्रिटिसाइज दैट बुक दे से दैट इट इज सो एंटीक्वेटेड सम वन आर ए फ्यू स्मॉल वेरी वेरी टाइनी पोर्शंस मे बी एंटीक्वेटेड बट देन देयर आर सो मेनी थिंग्स विच tell about eternal truths. So this is one such thing. Danda shasti prajas sarvaha. Danda actually means a rod. Danda, in Hindi also you use the word danda. Danda actually is danda in Hindi. That is dandam, raja danda, raja dandam. You see, in olden days, kings used to carry an ornamental staff. Staff means a stick, a long stick. Decorated, highly decorated stick in their hand. It was called a scepter, S-C-E-P-T-R-E, scepter. So that was the symbol of power. That was the symbol of the royal power. So whether you take Western society or even the Indian society, the kings carried that scepter. That is the symbol of authority. Even if you see gods in India, if we see our own gods, gods usually have four hands. In one hand, of course, there is a weapon. It shows that. That represents danda, it represents jurisprudence, it represents the fear of law. So this fear of law is what is talked about in this particular shloka. So this law is something which develops in any society. Law is something, it develops in the sense, for any society to survive, the society has to be led by some sort of government or some authority has to be there. And then the individuals also need some authority, individuals also need some rights. The society, the government also needs some rights. So the state and the individual, there is a balance of rights between the state and the individual. State derives its power from the individuals only. The individuals, as individuals, we surrender some of our powers to the state. We surrender our powers to the state to rule us. Otherwise the stronger man will be hitting the weaker man. If a strong man is hitting a weaker man, there is a need for somebody, an umpire, to come and then stop that fellow. So we surrender our powers, to our liberty to some extent, to the cop, to the state. The representative of the state is a cop, let us say. And that cop is a man who gives ticket to you. And when the cop gives ticket to you, it means that you have authorized him. He is deriving that power from you only. You have already given him that power to charge you, to give you a ticket, to fine you for any transgression. So that is what happens in a society. So it is a question of give and take. For our own protection, we have surrendered some of our freedom, some freedom of ours, to the state. And the state uses it in the form of police, it uses it in the form of some other, regulatory agencies, and then they control the people. So that is what is talked about here. Dandaha shasti prajas sarvaha. Danda is, there is law, order, regulatory, say mechanism, let us say. So in modern terms, if we see, the regulatory mechanism is what controls the society. Danda eva abhirakshati. And in fact, it is this rod, it is this law which controls the people. Without this law, people cannot be controlled. People will be acting in their own as they like. Then dandaha supteshu jagarti. This is a wonderful statement. Dandaha supteshu jagarti. Even when you are sleeping, janeshu supteshu satsu. This is what is called sati saptami. Even while the people are sleeping, what is it that is awake? It is the law which is awake. Law is awake when people are asleep. This is a very nice way of saying that law is something which is always wakeful. It is not simply in a literal way that a cop is doing some patrolling even in the night. There are some patrolling vehicles even in the night. That is a literal way. But even figuratively or metaphorically, law is something which is always present, which is always having, say, the power. That is why we use the word, the long arm of the law. The long arm of the law reaches the people wherever you are. So that is what we say. Danda supteshu jagarti, dandam dharmam vidur buddhaha. So that is why the people say, buddhaha means scholars or learned people. Learned people say that dandam is something which is dharma. So this dharma again, it is in two levels. One is at an ordinary social level. You see, in society there are two types of say regulations. One is a regulation which is enforceable by law. Enforceable means a cop can come, or some other regulatory authority can come, some tax man can come, or some other fireman can come and then impose some fine on you. That is something which is a regulatory function. There are some other things which cannot be regulated, which cannot be enforced. You have to respect your elders, you have to respect your parents, you have to respect your teachers, you have to say show some courtesies to your neighbors. There are various things like that. Of course, courtesies to neighbors means he can of course complain to police, etc. That's a different thing. If you don't respect your parents cannot say report to police. It is a question of ethics. It is a question of morality. You do suppose you are not a believer in anything. You are not a believer. You need not blindly believe, but religion is something which gives some little bit of discipline. So if you are not really, if you are not religious, okay, fine, it is all right. But then some discipline also is needed in a society. So a person who doesn't obey any say discipline, so such things, they are unenforceable. So that is why dharma talks about religion. Dharma also talks about, oh, there is somebody called God. If you do not do this, God will punish you. If you do some good act, suppose an act of charity, there is no law which can force you to give some donation to somebody. No law can force you. It is your own free will. No law can force you to do any other good act. It is your own, say, goodwill. So like that, okay, you do some good act, you will receive some reward in heaven. You are going to heaven, you will have some nice drinks there, some all those attractions. They are all some attractions which are shown to you. So like that, there are two levels in which law functions. That is dharma, in which dharma functions, that is ordinary law. And then there is what is called a sort of divine law. You can call it a divine law or something you can call it religion, whatever it is. So that is how this danda is something which is always there. So that is why when somebody is committing a mistake, so he is always afraid. He is afraid of law. He is also afraid of the God. So that is why even a thief, when a thief comes, he comes in such a stealthy manner. He does not come openly and then take away. He comes in such a stealthy manner because he also knows that what he is doing is wrong. So because he knows that what he is doing is wrong, he comes in such a stealthy way. So that the fear of law is something which is regulating the people to a large extent, regulating the society to a large extent. So this is what we see in this particular shloka. Let us read the shloka. दण्डस्यास्ति प्रजाः सर्वाः
दण्डस्यास्ति प्रजाः सर्वाः
दण्ड एव अभिरक्षति
दण्ड एव अभिरक्षति
दण्डसुप्तेषु जागर्ति
दण्डसुप्तेषु जागर्ति
दण्डं धर्मं विदुर्बुधाः
दण्डं धर्मं विदुर्बुधाः
इट इज सच अ नेचुरल थिंग लॉ इज सच अ नेचुरल थिंग इट इज इट कम्स इन एनी सोसाइटी इट डेवलप्स नेचुरली इवन इफ यू लीव सम 100 पीपल इन अ फॉरेस्ट. Suppose in a jungle you leave 100 people. So over a period of time, some leader emerges in that. Some leader, there is somebody who is advising that leader. There is somebody who is enforcing the order of that leader. So that is how primitive, in long, long ago, the primitive societies have evolved. So over a period of time, as civilization grew, and then as, understanding of human nature developed, naturally we have got finer and finer forms in the form of democracy. So that is what we see in this particular shloka. Fine.